Leave it up to Colin and the Donovan, right, cause that's the one. What's that? Up, oh, man. Let's get ready.
Bro, I'm just saying. So, when you look at the Daily Wire, Larry, you know who the Daily Wire is? The network, Shapiro and all that? Yeah.
Come on now.
What they have become such
Larry
an inspiration.
Of course,
to
he knows who the Daily Wire is.
Because of how much they've grown. And yeah. I don't know how much you've heard about all this stuff now, but like, yeah, because like, they were talking about on the election night and all that good stuff, breaking all this new stuff. I mean, they're getting into like massive media space where they're going to start making like movies and TV and like actual entertainment shows.
Really?
Oh yeah. And I'm just like, man, from where they started to where they are now, it's totally possible.
No,
it's totally 100%. Possible.
And like, cause have you heard of, what's it called? Larry Elder made Uncle Tom and Dinesh, what's his
D'Souza.
Name? Yeah. He made, the Trump card. And those did massively. And then I think Carell, oh God, he's a comedian.
Adam Carolla?
Yeah, Adam Carolla. So there he made one too about like colleges, right? Like kind of that group thing on campuses.
Yeah.
And like what they saw is that like all three of those did better. And then so like Daily Wire is essentially now they're starting to congregate kind of the free thought, because like the big problem that they have is like they have small budgets, but they're scattered. But like Daily Wire could not compete with CNN and Larry Elder at Epic Times couldn't compete with MSNBC. So like they're starting to pull resources and then create like the alternative to the entertainment options right now. So like that was one, because I thought Uncle Tom was one where I bought it when Larry Elder came out with that, and I thought that was like it was very insightful on like the opposite side of like the conversation about being black, where like we had one that was very pervasive through all medias and like all social media, and like that one was just like it was counterintuitive, and a lot of people had said like a lot of things, but it was a very cool perspective. So I think that's what Daily Wire is trying to do. Like I saw them scoop up Candace Owens, and I think they combine with PragerU.
Yeah, they're merging with PragerU. They're going to become part of them too. Yeah.
Okay.
So the entirety of the PragerU library will be available on Daily Wire after their whole thing's done. Whenever it I mean, it's all 100%. Like coming down the pike. But
damn.
Yeah, it's just the growth there, man, is so inspirational to watch. Like regardless of the fact that they're kind of trying to remake media and they're the new media and they're staking their flag on their conservative bent and all that. Like, regardless of that aspect of it, just this emergent media market that is coming online. And I think you're definitely onto something where you're talking about like essentially for that ideology of entertainment, it's so scattered and so nobody can really compete with the big wigs of CNN and MSNBC and Fox News and stuff like that.
Right.
But if somebody gets big enough so they can start getting people into it, like even like the Blaze TV tried to do for a while, and they're relatively big.
They are. They just scooped up Dave Rubin not too long ago. So the Blaze, Crowder's been on there just a couple of years, and then they got Dave Rubin within the last year. Yep. So
the two of them either need to combine forces, I think, or essentially work hand in hand together going up, because they're both massive.
Crowder this week actually celebrated having more overall subscribership than the Young Turks.
That is magical. And that's
off of like independent purchasing of their subscriptions, where the Young Turks have taken tens of millions of dollars of money from corporate donors and
they're the Joe Biden of the political punditry wing.
And
that's why I thought that you guys were in a very interesting bubble. Like, this is how I always saw you guys, right? This is why I find you as fascinating. Well, you guys are cool, dude. So, but like what you're doing, I find fascinating, because like in my world, right? Like in my thought of just education, right? Like, I don't know if it's school choice. I like a decentralized approach to education. And then that's where people like you guys become so important, right? Because you guys are working as hard as you can to like, hey, like, this is what I think, this is where we are, and this is where you are. And so, like, because you guys are working so hard to straddle that line, I really think, like, that kind of education could be important, because, like, what we're seeing is on both sides, like, there's at times they're low-information citizens, right? And it's the low-information citizens that kind of get taken advantage of. And that's on both sides in both situations. But, like, I was shocked on, like, you guys saw, like, the woman who was just like, I didn't know Joe Biden was advocating for more shutdowns.
Yes, oh. The doctor.
Yeah, the
doctor who said this.
And that's what I, like, and that's when it hit me. And, like, I heard other people say it, but, like, that's what hit me. I was just like, there's no one's, like, dumb, right? There's dumb people. But, like, in my eyes, no one's dumb, but, like, there's a low information.
Yeah.
And, like, no one has, people they're not tuning up. Exactly, like, to what's going on. And you see it a lot with people who are super busy. For like, I have like friends that are like, I'm only growing my business. That's all I care about. But then they come and talk, and they're just ignorant on an issue because I'm just like, you don't know, and not that you don't have the capacity to know, but like right. What have you done to bridge this gap? So that's why I think you guys are super interesting, because like that's kind of your goal, is to bring people in. And like with those shorts that you guys are coming out, I think they're incredible. Clips. The clips, right? I like shorts. Clips, that's fine. Clips.
Shorts, call them whatever you want, bro. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, and I think chewing on a three-hour podcast can be intimidating, especially when you're not going to know a lot of material, but, like, those 10 minutes where you're, like, it just, like, make you think. And then, like, if your thing could be, like, hey, like, continue this journey of thought. Because, like, you guys disagreed on who you guys were going to vote. Well, you guys kind of – you Colin kind of late hour said he was going somewhere else with it. But even at the same time, you guys were like, okay, these are all the facts. Like, you guys went, like, you guys pulled up the brochure. Like, these are the objectives on our voting block this year. This is what it means. Like, let's talk about it. And you guys are making such informed decisions. And, like, that is massive, to not direct someone, but to teach someone how to find stuff, to teach someone how to think, rather what to think. And I think that's why I find, like, salt of the street so fascinating.